Hey there everyone, it's Mrs. D. Thanks for coming by and thanks for checking out this video. This video is What is Outschool? Okay, for those of you who have not been privy to the online teaching industry, if you're just starting to break through and you've heard about Outschool as a parent or as a teacher, this is mostly geared towards teachers, but you know, parents could be interested in this as well. Outschool is an online learning teacher marketplace. So teacher lists classes, students look for classes, sign up for classes, and connect that way. And they do that through Zoom. A note about Zoom, you can make a free account for Zoom, but you do not have to pay for Zoom, which is very expensive. I've paid for it in the past. Outschool provides the paid version of Zoom for you. So a note about the settings, you can't really change the settings. You can't record on your own computer, things like that for safety purposes. But Outschool provides the paid version of Zoom for you, and you just go into the class that you've listed and you click the live meeting button, and it just kind of, you know, goes into a live Zoom classroom where your students will also connect with you. You're not supposed to share the Zoom link or password with anybody else because Outschool is really big on safety. So anyways, let's talk about how it's a teacher marketplace. Let's think about Facebook Marketplace, okay? Facebook Marketplace, you have something you want to sell, whether you've made it or you have, you have something in your house, you want to sell it. You just put a picture up and you put a little description on there and you put a price on there and then you put it out there for the world to look at and hopefully make a sale, right? So that's kind of like how Outschool is. You have a class, you want to teach it, you fill all the requirements out for the class listing, you post it, and then you hope that learners will enroll in your class, okay? So you are not employed by Outschool, you are not contracted by Outschool, but you are just, you're just listing on their marketplace, and they do take a 30% commission for marketing, some marketing that they do for you. They also pay their employees, they pay for their server, they pay for Zoom through that 30% that they take from every learner that pays, okay? So, like I said, Outschool is big on rules. They're really big on communication, they're big on safety, and they also want to, guard their profit, their profit margin. So they want to keep everything on the platform. They don't want you poaching students. They don't want safety to be an issue with students. So what else? COPPA compliant, okay? So that's protection of children from having their data collected. So their names, their addresses, any of their personal information. That's what the COPPA compliancy is all about. When you're teaching students that are 13 and under, it means that you cannot give them a website where they're going to click the link and go to the website and browse around, because those particular websites will collect their data or ask them for information that, some kids might just put in there without thinking about internet safety. So that's what COPPA compliant is all about. If they're 13 and up, it's not an issue. And Outschool provides a list of approved websites and not approved websites. And it also provides you a place where you can enter the website so that they can check it out and say, yes, it's COPPA compliant and you may use it, or no, it's not. Now let's talk about YouTube videos for a second in there. YouTube is not COPPA compliant, but Outschool has come up with some kind of coding that they do where they put, if you put the link in the classroom, in the Outschool classroom, that link will open another window, and it's a safe window. It doesn't collect information from the students. As long as you're putting it into the classroom, like as in a comment, like if you're going to write a comment as a teacher, if you're going to send a note out to everybody as a teacher, you just put that URL in that area, and then it will be COPPA compliant through the coding that Outschool has provided. I try not to send kids to YouTube, and I like to download and upload to Google, which I'll do a different video about for that, because it's safer, and a lot of, some people don't want to use YouTube at all. So if you list it in your listing, they might not even look at you. So anyways, that's not the purpose of this video. Also copyright, okay, because we are profit teachers, we are for-profit teachers, we have to do our due diligence and look into copyright information, whether it's copyright laws, fair use laws, whatever it is, you've got to look at the copyright information. Get permission for things that you want to use that might be under copyright. I'm not going to give any advice on that. Outschool will not give you any advice on that. That's going to be on you as a teacher to go ahead and research out. Okay, and let's see what else. On Outschool, you can teach whatever you want. So if you want to teach cooking classes, go ahead. If you want to teach girls and boys to put makeup on and do their hair, you can teach that. There's a teacher on there that teaches yo-yo skills. You can really teach anything that you want on Outschool, from, you know, that kind of stuff right up to academics. I teach a lot of English classes, courses on there. So, you know, really anything. And you don't have to have a degree. You just have to have experience, and you have to be able to prove that you are capable of teaching that when you apply and when you list your classes. Okay. So, also the listings, anything that you teach has to be secular. So there's no, you know, there's no Christianity. There's not supposed to be any kind of religion at all, but they're really big on Christianity. Like, you can't even use Abeka books because they've, you know, they mention Christianity or they mention God. So just so you know that going into it, it has to be secular and it has to be gender inclusive. So you can't list only for girls or only for boys. So you can list, you know, girls club, but it can't be only for girls club. It has to be open to everybody, and you have to be gender inclusive. And Outschool is really supportive of listing pronouns and, you know, just making sure that every teacher and every student is gender inclusive. So keep that in mind as well as you're considering Outschool. And let's talk about how I do it as the business aspect of it. Because we're not contracted, because we're not employed, I list myself as self-employed and an independent contractor with some companies. And I have a business bank account. And what I do is all of the money that I get, whether it's PayPal, Payoneer, you know, a Venmo, whatever form of payment I get, it goes into that bank account. And from that bank account, I can distribute it elsewhere. But everything goes into that bank account, acts like a funnel so that I can keep track of exactly how much I'm making. I can take out taxes for that. And I also use QuickBooks so that I can easily mark what things are for. If I buy products on Amazon for the business, or if, you know, it's personal, or if, you know, I'm moving funds to the savings account for the business to pay for taxes, or I'm moving funds to my personal account, it's just easier to go from business using QuickBooks. And I use a CPA, and that is because my husband has his own business. I have my own business. We own a house. We have 5 kids. Laws are always changing, and I just don't have the time or non-anxiety to file our own taxes. I pay for a CPA to do that. I pay through the nose for the CPA to do that. We also pay for audit protection so that if we do get audited by the IRS, the CPA will handle that and we don't have to worry about the stress of that. So that is how I, you know, go about, you know, dealing with running, because it's your own business. It's not, you know, you're not contracted, you're not employed. So it's your own business. So you list as self-employed, you get yourself a business bank account, you can use QuickBooks, you can do your own taxes if you want to, but it's, you know, that's how you approach it as your own business, as a self-employed business. So I hope this video has been helpful to you to kind of figure out what Outschool is in a nutshell. Okay. And if you are interested in becoming a teacher, please click the link, email me, message me on Facebook at Mrs. D on Facebook. Just look for Mrs. D on Facebook. And I'd be happy to help you get started, give you advice. There's other videos on here about getting hired, what to do to fill out the application process. And there's also other videos about how to list classes and things like that. So if you enjoyed this video, if you're interested in other videos, please like, subscribe, leave a comment if you have any questions about anything that I've said here or anything that I might not have thought of to put in the video. And I look forward to our next video. See you later.